everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. Myself Atisha Garg, and today in this video, I'm going to talk about the complete data science roadmap that you can follow to start your career as a data scientist in 2021. Before actually starting the video, let me tell you one thing, that this video is for everyone who wants to get into this field but don't know from where to actually start. And even if you don't have any computer science background or any mathematics background, then also you can follow these steps and kickstart your career in the field of data science. So let's start the video. First and foremost thing to kickstart your career in the field of data science is to learn a programming language. So there are two commonly used programming languages in the field of data science, that is Python and R. You can get started with any of the languages from these two. There are other programming languages as well, but it's better to use a language that is mostly used in the industry, because these Python and R, they have huge libraries because of which people rely more on these languages. So how you have to get started with learning these programming languages is, first you have to learn the basics of it. For example, what are variables, what are functions, what are loops, etc. And then you have to move on to the OOPs concept. After you are comfortable with the OOPs concept, what you have to learn is the libraries. For example, in Python, you have libraries like NumPy, Pandas, then you have Matplotlib, Seaborn, etc. These libraries will be very, very useful for you. Learning about these libraries will play a crucial role in your data science projects later on. So it's very important to go about this programming language in the way that I've told you. Now coming on to the second step. The second step is to get familiar with four main subjects, namely statistics, linear algebra, probability, and calculus. Now, why is it important to have an idea about these subjects? Is basically because these subjects basically will be serving as a foundation whenever you will be dealing with data and its analysis in data science. Even if you don't have a mathematics background earlier, or you haven't even touched mathematics after 10th standard, then also I'll be telling you what are the basic things that you have to learn. Now, the next question that will be going through your mind is what order you have to follow in order to learn these subjects. So in the order that I'll be telling you about each and every subject, the same order you can follow to learn these subjects as well. Now, coming on to the first subject, that is statistics. So under statistics, you should know the basic terms related to it, like what is mean, what is median, mode, then covariance, standard deviation, etc. And guys, keep in mind one thing. Only knowing the formula would not work. You should know what mean represents, what median represents, how after seeing the data, whenever you will calculate the mean, what will that data represent? So that is very, very important, right? Now coming on to the second subject, that is linear algebra. So in linear algebra, you should know about vectors, matrices, and matrices. Under matrices, you should know how you have to manipulate the data using matrices. What are the different matrices operations? Because the data which you will be having that might be in higher dimensions as well. So at that point of time, matrices will play a very crucial role. Apart from that, in linear algebra, you can get into learning what are eigenvalue, what are eigenvectors, what is Gram-Schmidt process, then what is basis, what is dimension. I know these terms might not be familiar to you, but once you will learn what these terms mean and how you have to go about it, then it will be very easy for you and you will get comfortable with it gradually, right? Now coming on to the third subject, that is calculus. So in calculus, basic thing is to have an understanding about the derivatives. What is first derivative? What is second derivative? And here, not only just knowing what are these derivatives, you should actually know what is the meaning of d by dx, what is the meaning of d2y by dx square. So what is x, what is y, what is the second variable depicting, what is this first variable depicting. So each and everything you should know thoroughly. Now coming on to the fourth and the last subject, that is probability. So understanding probability is also very important if you want to get into this data science field. So under probability, you should have understanding of the basic terms like what is odds, what is random experiment, what is conditional probability, what is Bayes' theorem, and you should also have idea about the different types of distributions that are there, like normal distribution, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, etc. So after understanding all these subjects thoroughly, then you have to move on to the next step, that is step 3. Now coming to the third step. The third step is to know about the data visualization tools. However, it's not mandatory to learn about these data visualization tools at such an early stage, but it will be very much required whenever you will go for internships or jobs in this field, because the companies who will be hiring you will demand that you must know these data visualization tools. So why not learn it at an initial stage itself, right? So as the name suggests, these data visualization tools basically help you see, help you visualize large amount of data, understand the patterns, understand the trends, and understand the outliers that are there in the data. So if you are getting started with it, then you can start with Excel. So if the data is not very huge, then Excel would solve the purpose. So in Excel, you can learn about the data filters, then you can learn about VBA macros, you can learn about pivot tables, etc. And if you want to go into handling more data, then there are some other data visualization tools as well that you can learn, like Tableau, Power BI, then Google Studio, etc. So these are the tools from which you can choose from, and there are many other tools as well out of which you can choose any. The fourth step is the most crucial step in your data science journey, and that is to learn about machine learning algorithms. So this is one of the topics that will take your maximum time, but if you work wholeheartedly, then you will be able to get it. And it's very important to have good command over machine learning algorithms. So machine learning algorithms basically are divided into four categories: supervised, unsupervised, semi-supervised, and reinforcement learning. So under each of these categories that I've told you, there are several other machine learning algorithms that are there. Like there is logistic regression, there is linear regression, decision tree, KNN, and many more. So overall, there are top 15 ML algorithms you should know properly. And you should also know the mathematics behind it, because what you will get to know is in the interviews, basically the math behind these machine learning algorithms is being asked. So if you are not thorough with it, you will lose that opportunity. So that is why understanding the maths behind it is also important. And if you would have followed the step two properly, that is learning about those four subjects that I have told you, then understanding the math behind these algorithms would be a piece of cake for you. Now for deploying these machine learning algorithms, the most commonly used and the most robust library in Python is scikit-learn. So for deploying all these algorithms that you are learning, you can use scikit-learn. Other libraries are also there, like TensorFlow, Theano, etc. But the most commonly used one is scikit. So it depends on you, whichever library you want to have to deploy the machine learning algorithms that you have learned. Now, once you are done with all the four steps that I've told you previously, you have to jump onto this last step. That is the very important step, that is to learn about deep learning. Now, under deep learning, you have to majorly focus upon three algorithms, that is artificial neural network, convolutional neural network, and recurrent neural network, right? Now, for deploying these deep learning algorithms, the most commonly used library is TensorFlow. So you can start with that. I know all these terms that I'm talking about, if you are new into this field, you might not understand it. But once you dive deep into this data science career, data science field, you will learn each and everything properly. Apart from all these steps, you should also have knowledge about databases and Git. Why databases? Because since you will be working in the field of data science, you will be dealing with huge amount of data. And it's very important to know how to structurally store that data. So for that purpose, having understanding of databases is important. And why Git? Because all the projects that you will be building, you can put on your Git profile, and that Git profile you can also show in your resume. So whenever you will go for interview, either for an internship or for a job, the interviewer can have a look at your Git profile and get an understanding that yes, these so and so work that a person has done in the field of data science, right? So guys, this is the roadmap that you need to follow in order to kickstart your career in the field of data science in 2021. These are the basic steps. If you follow, you will surely get a job or internship in this field.